Howdy folks, I'm planning to conclude my phase converter build videos today, and at the risk of rendering myself in need of major chiropractic repairs, I got this big motor out of the back of my barn. Now I misspoke yesterday. I said it was a 25 horse. It's actually a 20. And again, that's just because I hadn't, messed with it so long. It was something that came with another piece of equipment that I bought and ended up not using the motor. So it is full load amps is 51 amps on the 220 volt three phase. So, six times that roughly for locked rotor current, that's going to be a lot of amps. And my concern is that it will cause an instant trip of the 50 amp circuit, branch circuit that powers this this welder outlet. We'll see. It's either going to cause an immediate trip there, or it'll cause such a voltage sag that it causes the control relay inside the phase converter to just turn off. So we're going to find out shortly. I did put a little grease in it. The bearings don't sound so good. There's no telling how long it's been since it's run. But nothing else to do but try it. I'm going to go ahead and start the Allis-Chalmers motor. Try to get back where you can see the motor and the amp meter in the video. Okay, so that's a little better. You can at least see the pulley on the big motor, see if it moves at all, and possibly be able to see the current draw. So here goes nothing. All tripped. Okay, I'll go reset that. We'll give it one more try. Okay, I reset that. We'll give it one more shot here. This time I'm just going to video the current meter, and then if it starts, I'll cut over to the big motor. All right, 3, 2, 1, start. Hey, it's running. The bearings don't sound very good. Like I said, I greased it. Shut it off. So now, I hope you can hear me. My plan originally was to use that motor for a phase converter. And if this one doesn't hold up or doesn't work out, that's what I'll do. Obviously, after putting new bearings in it. So I'm going to check the voltage balance on the output of the phase converter with the no load on it. So I'm going to turn on the output contactor, and now I've got my meter here. So measuring phase to phase, A to C, we got 242. Now if I measure from A to B, 225, and B to C, 226. So you can see there's slightly less voltage there, and I could adjust that by increasing the run capacitor rating, but with no load on it, I'm not too concerned about it. If I measure from ground to A, I get 121. Ground to C, I get 121. However, ground to B, it's a lot higher.
That's why that B phase is only useful for motor starting. It kind of is similar to a delta system with a center tapped neutral on one side of the delta, which is, I don't know if it's still common, but it used to be really common. And you'd have what they call the high leg or a wild leg, which was your B phase in most places. So this kind of simulates that. Now I'm going to hook the ginormous oversized motor up and see what the voltages look like with that motor running. So once I start the motor, it's going to be hard to hear me. So just I'm going to do the same measurement of phase-to-phase voltages. I'm going to measure A to C, which is the same as the incoming single phase. Still got 240. A to B, 228. B to C, same 228. So there's about a 10 volt difference. And again, if I wanted to add capacitors, I could correct that. But I never intend to run a motor this big off this converter, so I'm not going to try to adjust it for this motor. Okay, I've got the controls box open on the phase converter. And remember, this is the boost capacitor contactor. That's the start capacitor contactor. So I'm gonna make one last start of that big 20 horsepower motor, and we'll see what the potential relays are doing, because the potential relays control those. So here we go for a start. Okay, so what that tells me is, you saw the start relay did not kick back in again. That tells me that the output voltage stayed above 90 volts during that start. And that's really all that I can tell by that, but I just wanted to see. I'm going to turn off the motor. You see the boost contactor turned off, that's working properly. Okay, I've got this, I believe it's about a 6 horsepower motor hooked up, and I'm going to start it, and we'll measure the phase voltages with that motor running. Going for a start. Now I'm going to go back and measure A to C, which should be the same as incoming voltage. And now, C to B and A to B. So 241, 237, 4 volts difference. 235 there, 4 or 5 volts difference. For no load, you would expect it to be good like that. I wish I had a motor like this with an active load on it that I could use to see what happens. But looking at other people's tests they've done online on YouTube, most of the guys seem to run their equipment no load when they're doing voltage checks. So I guess comparing apples to apples, it's doing perfect. Next time I refurbish one of the big three-phase ILG fans, I will redo this test with the load on the motor and see what happens. That motor seems to have pretty good bearings. That is a 2-horse motor hooked up. We're going to see what kind of voltage balance we get running that 2-horse motor. Here goes for power on. Well, you know what? It'll work better if I plug the test cord into the converter. All right, here we go for power on for real. Now check A to C again. That will be the same as incoming line, 241. A to B, 223. B to C, 225. And you notice that the B phase voltages are lower with that small motor because it doesn't provide enough load on the converter for the boost capacitors to come on. That's just the nature of having a design that uses that sort of switching on and off capacitors. It's only got two choices, on or off. And a small motor like this is going to get less B-phase voltage because it does not engage those capacitors. Will it hurt? I doubt it. If you're a perfectionist, then it might bother you, but I don't think the motor's going to care. Switch it off. So now I have this the 10 horsepower Brook motor with its really treacherous pulley with the two bolt heads on it. I set that one on cardboard because that pulley's not well balanced, and due to vibration it'll literally walk around on the concrete floor in search of a person to catch their pants leg in those bolts. So to keep it stationary, I put it on that cardboard pad. Then down here I have the meter and the junction block. So we'll start it up and check our phase voltages. Well, you see, it's already walking. Looks like I'm going to need a better pad than that cardboard. Let's see if that car floor mat keeps it still. Yeah, that's better. So again, with the 10 horsepower motor running no load, 241 A to B, 235, 236. So boost capacitors are on with that one, and it's pretty well balanced. I think since the last video I hadn't showed the output outlet that I put on here. It's the same style as my other converter. The only thing that ever gets plugged in is this test cord. I think this outlet really is not intended for three phase. I believe it's meant for a dedicated neutral. A single phase, two lives, and the neutral and ground are separate. But the only thing this ever gets used for is a test cord. So it's not like someone else is going to use it and plug something in there wrong. And I like to physically disconnect this before I handle the wiring, and instead of trying to trust the contactor. So yeah, about all the troll comments, I had just wanted to be sure that all the guys that have posted comments on this video and that I've responded to and interacted with, nobody that I interacted with or responded to here or on Facebook or anywhere was who I was talking about. And I didn't intend for it to sound that way, and I hope it didn't, but I just wanted to clarify that. So in looking on YouTube, there's a good many people that have shared phase converter stuff. And some of them have built minimalist designs that probably serve their purpose very well, but might not be adequate for larger motors or for any kind of sensitive equipment. And other people have built, you know, big designs with a lot of complexity that would do almost anything. And every one of those has a place. You have a real simple machine tool, one three-phase drill press. You built a simple capacitor box with a start cap and a potential relay, and it works great. Next guy has a big air compressor motor, big heavy constant load on it, and he tries that and it fails. Well, you know, the fault isn't the guy that built the simple converter and had it work on his equipment. That's not it. And the thing that that these trolls seem to be failing at is understanding that there's a place for pretty much every design, from the simplest to the most complex. And they seem to get a charge out of criticizing anything that doesn't include every design element that they're aware of. And that's just a sign of insecurity. But, enough of that. If you have a need for a really complex, sophisticated converter, by all means, buy it, build it. If you only need a start box for a single motor, buy that or build it. No need to go out and criticize everyone else. It seems like, as with most things, where there's a lot of content on YouTube, that's where the trolls come out of the woodwork. And they seem to be onto the phase converter guys. I would have never expected that until I built this, but I found out the hard way. Anyway, catch you later.